Looks like this is our lucky day.
Yeah, this might actually go smoothly.
We deserve it after last time. Made up your mind yet?
About what?
When it comes to the getting the hell out of Macon, I bet you're in the let's stay put camp considering I've been pushing everyone to leave.
We should go. The motel's run its course, and it's not safe.
Well, if that's what you think, you should probably fucking speak up. Lily's dug in. Okay, just like last time. Over the rig, into the pharmacy, and scrape together whatever supplies are left.
We didn't leave much in there.
Hey, we're out of options. Something's better than nothing. Shit.
You okay?
The ladder's come loose. I'm not sure how many more trips she's got in her.
I'm not sure how many more trips we've got in us.
No kidding.
Looks like she's had it.
What now?
I'll find another way up.
We better get a move on.
There's no safe way through that mess. They're blocked by all the fallen concrete. They're blocked by all the fallen concrete. Looks like it still works.
Lily's not doing so good, huh?
It's not good. I'm worried.
No shit. There's a lot to be worried about. She's gonna snap.
Completely flat.
The girl still upset with you for agreeing to take that stuff from the station wagon?
I think she understands.
Hope so. Not like we had much choice.
Right.
Duck was asking about that guy at Herschel's farm last night.
Really? I wasn't sure it fazed him.
Of course it did.
It was a scary situation for him, Sean dying and all.
I'm just worried he'll always think it was his fault.
You're sure you're up for this?
Lee, I'm fine. I've got this. Give me your hand. Shit!
Thought you said you could handle it.
You ever been shot before? I'm sorry. Christ. You'd think you'd... is that? A walker?
Walkers don't scream, do they?
Jesus, I don't think so.
It's a girl. We have to help her.
How? There's no getting to her.
We gotta do something. Fuck. We gotta shoot her. Put her out of this misery.
I don't know we're here.
What do you mean?
I mean, we leave her alive, and she draws them all to her, buying us time.
Can't.
Think about it. We're always worrying about the ones we can't see. She stays alive and brings them all out of their holes. Should be good to clear this place out, but we ain't got all day. Get everything you can out of these racks. Don't forget underneath the counter this time. I'll clear down here and then we gotta go. She's gone. There's not much time now.
I think that's everything.
That girl didn't die for nothing, then. Up and over. We're still clear. Let's hustle.
Oh! Jimmy, help!
You're back. Ben found some stickers in a drawer, and I put them on my walkie.
Hey, sweet pea. That's neat. I'll find you in a minute.
Looks like we got the kid on watch again.
What'd you get?
We might as well leave a sign out that says the men are gone and come and rape our women and children.
Huh. So, what did you get?
Just what was left.
Which was a lot, actually. Take a look. We're fine, by the way.
Nice work. This'll keep us going. If we carry on like this, we'll get through the winter here.
The winter? We'll freeze our asses off here!
Because piling into an RV with you after what you did to my dad is so appealing.
Why wouldn't it be? You know I'll do what it takes to keep everyone safe.
We have to go eventually, Lily.
I know, Lee. I know. Eventually is different. At it again, are we?
Can it, Carly?
Don't boss people around.
I'm sorry. Somebody needs to make executive decisions for the group, though. And I don't think you're capable anymore.
Everything can't come down to the same disagreement. Lily's concerns are valid, you know.
Of course you think they are.
God damn it, I'm not on anyone's side, Kenny. This is about everyone.
What about the food situation? What about protection? What about when this place falls? Somebody's got to be thinking about this shit.
How has this not been working? We have everything we need.
Because of me, Lily.
No, because Lee knows how to take care of people, not just things.
We deal with shit as it comes, just like we always do.
And when 15 bandits hop over that wall in the middle of the night? What then? You just gonna deal with that?
Everything that happens to us is another excuse for you to pull this crap about leaving. All I want is a week of peace, of not hearing it.
Do you know how we got these supplies? Your pal and I got lucky and let a girl get eaten out there.
What?
Some girl came screaming out of an alley. She had dead hanging all over her. She gave us enough time to get everything we could out of the drugstore.
And you just let her suffer like what? Like bait? God, what is happening?
She was dead anyway. It made the most sense in the moment.
Lee's right. We've been putting our lives on the line doing these runs into the city. You wouldn't believe the shit we see.
We all appreciate it, Ken.
You should be thanking Lee for not shooting that girl.
It's not so easy for him.
Look, Macon and its people aren't savable. It's not a town. It's full of walkers, and the people who were left are dying and wandering out onto the streets. It's hell on earth, and it's coming this way.
It's not going to be easier out on the road!
How would you know?
What I know? I know you're not above murder. I know somebody has been stealing our supplies. That's right, stealing! And I know the list of people I can trust here gets smaller every day! Now everybody get out!
She'll get over it.
She's riling everybody up otherwise.
You understand, Ken.
All I know is, whenever this shit happens, I'm the fucking bad guy. I'd like a thank you for once. For once!
Ooh, things are coming to a head.
You could say that.
Well, I think you did good today. And I find myself thinking that most days.
Thanks.
It's probably worth following up with Lily about what she was saying about missing supplies. With her wound up the way she is, I don't want to see her paranoid.
No question.
And I'd like to talk when you've got a minute.
It's Lily's room.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to apologize.
Did you come in here to give me hell or to coddle me?
I think you're coming unhinged.
I know. I'm trying. I feel like a crazy person.
Can I do anything for you?
Yes. I need help. There's a traitor. Somebody. One of us. Out there. He or she or they have been taking things.
For real? Who? What do you got?
Yes, for real. And I don't have shit. I just know.
Lily.
Counts off and it's the good stuff. Antibiotics, oxy, fuck, anything with opium in it.
I see the count, and it's fine.
I keep my own. That one's getting messed with. I'm a fucking mess right now, but I'm not stupid. I know what happens if I start a witch hunt.
So you want me to start one?
I want you to poke around.
What's there to go on?
I found this tossed into the garbage.
Huh.
We don't toss out equipment, we fix it. You'd only try to get rid of a flashlight if you're using it when you shouldn't.
Okay, I'll poke around a little bit.
Thank you.
A mystery.
Jesus, Doc.
I'm sorry. I heard you guys talking.
You need to unhear all of that.
Can I help?
What did I just say?
You're the Grace Detective, and I can be Dick Grayson, your ward. That's Robin.
I know who it is. Okay, you're Robin.
Yes. What do I do?
I don't know. Go look around. Let me know if you find anything weird.
I'm on the case.
Talk to Lily yet?
Yeah, she thinks supplies have been walking away.
Really?
There's some broken equipment, too. I'll look into it.
Thanks for doing that. What I wanted to say was, I've been thinking a lot about you.
What about?
You're a convicted killer.
Carly, Jesus.
And I think people should know. Not because they deserve to, and not because you're a bad man. I think the opposite of those two things. People need to know because we're hanging by a thread here, and I can't see Lily talk about you without thinking it's the next thing she's going to say. You don't have to tell everyone, but think about who you trust and take the opportunity while you have it.
You're probably right.
Of course I'm probably right. People might be pissed. And telling them might cause some trouble, but it will be a far cry from what'll happen if they don't hear it from you.
Yeah.
So you'll do it then?
I'll let people know. You're totally right.
Good. I think it's for the best. You'll thank me later. Now, is there anything else you want to talk about?
Do you feel safe here?
Show me a bath with a heated floor and a high-rise apartment and hand me a full-bodied Malbec and then I'll feel safe. I don't know. This place is fine, but we all know that that could change at any second.
You really think people are ready to hear about me?
It's not a matter of ready or not. There's never going to be a good time, but there are going to be a lot of bad ones. Right now doesn't seem like one of them. But everyone's different. Who knows how each person would take it, you know? Maybe it's worth thinking about who you want to tell.
Do you know anything about this flashlight?
It's broken.
I know it's broken.
And the batteries might be in backwards.
It uses just one.
Everything should. What was the question?
Did you break the flashlight?
No.
Okay. You, have any thoughts about Lily?
I worry about her. That's about it. She keeps trying to run things, but it's just not working.
I'm gonna look into this thing.
Good idea.
Hey, Clementine.
Hey, Lee.
What's that you're working on, Clem?
It's called a leaf rubbing. My teacher, Miss Moore, showed us how to do them when we went to the botanical garden once. See? It's the same. Kind of.
Oh, that's really something.
I'll make one for you, too.
Do you like it here?
I don't like it here.
Do you want to leave?
Where are we going?
Somewhere else.
I don't know. Maybe if I knew where?
Yeah, that'd be a good thing to know. You didn't accidentally break a flashlight, did you?
No. Did Duck say I did?
No. Did Duck break the flashlight?
I don't think so. He's just always blaming me for stuff.
Like what?
Putting a bug on his pillow.
Did you do that?
Yes.
Clem, I need to talk to you for a second.
Okie dokie.
The day you and I met, I was in a car accident.
I remember. Your leg was bleeding.
The car I was in was a police car, and I was on my way to jail for committing a crime. I need to tell you now, because I don't want you to hear it any other way.
Okay.
Do you have anything to say?
I don't think so.
You can go on back to your things. Hey, you two. How are you doing?
We're okay.
Just having a little spat.
We all carry guns now, and I don't like it.
It's the way it's gotta be.
I know, but I'm not getting used to it. I'm sorry. How are you, Lee?
Do you guys know anything about this broken flashlight?
Fuck. We don't got many of those.
Yeah, it's a problem. The glass and the bulb are all busted out.
I saw some broken glass over by the ice machine. I meant to clean it up before the kids hurt themselves on it. I forgot, though.
About the guns.
Don't you start.
I just wanted to say, Kat, it's probably good they make you uncomfortable.
Thank you, Lee.
But we need them. There's no doubt about that. Kenny, you got a second? I need to tell you something.
Yeah? What do you got?
It's serious.
Okay, should I sit down?
Come on. I killed someone. Different than Larry or the St. John's, different from everything. This was before the Walkers.
A citizen?
Yes. I know. I didn't say anything when I met you because I was with the girl and, you know, I was worried.
Look, we've all done gnarly shit now. But what? You were some kind of killer?
It's not like that.
Is Duck safe around you?
Of course.
Good. But you should know, if we gotta make numbers when it comes to a boat, this is gonna matter. I appreciate it, though.
Sounds like Kenny actually has that thing running. I'll believe it when I see it. Hey, Ben.
What's up, Lee?
Did you ever come down here to Macon much?
I didn't have much reason to. My parents would let me take the car into the city on the weekend. But what's in Macon? It's kind of a waste of time compared to Atlanta.
I grew up in Macon.
Oh, I didn't mean to say it's crappy or anything. It's super nice. I mean, not now, but I bet it was. Is...
A flashlight was broken. Was it you?
No.
You're not in trouble if it was. I know you get nervous and maybe you went out to go to the bathroom, broke it, got worried and tossed it.
What's with the third degree? I didn't break any flashlight.
Okay, then. What do you think about Lily?
She scares the crap out of me.
That's a reasonable thing to feel.
I'm just worried she's going to snap.
Talk to you later, Ben.
Bye.
There's some broken glass on the ground there. There's something drawn there. Chalk.
Pink.
Doc!
A clue!
Maybe.
What do you think it is?
I don't think it's anything.
Maybe it's a sign.
It could be. It's pink chalk, which is weird.
Okay, back to investigating.
Hey.
Find anything?
Do you ever want to leave here?
I want to leave here when we have to, not because of some fantasy of somewhere better.
So, you think the coast is a pipe dream?
Don't you? We're going to live on the water because we assume they can't swim? We're alive because we've stayed here. That's as far as the discussion needs to go.
I need to tell you something.
Sure, go ahead. But if it's bad news, maybe save it.
I killed someone before all of this.
Shit.
What?
Dad said there was something about you.
So you know?
I didn't know what to know.
Well, it's true, and I'm sorry.
He treated you like shit, knew who you were, and you tried to save his life. The last thing you need to do is apologize.
Thank you.
You killed a guy. So what? I bet he was a dick.
Well, it ruined my life.
Good thing everyone else has got destroyed shortly thereafter, huh? Misery loves company.
Talk to Kenny about who I am.
And?
I don't know. Feels like I just gave him ammo if we ever have to make any tough decisions when it comes to a headcount.
Well, don't worry.
I talked to Clementine about things.
How'd she handle it?
I don't know. She's tough to read.
She adores you. Don't worry.
I told Lily. You were right. She and Larry spoke, obviously. She was all right, though.
Well, you're about all she's got left.
Do you have any chalk I can borrow?
What, Clementine holding out on you?
So you don't have any?
No, why would I?
I'll talk to you later.
I'll talk to you later.
Hey, Ben, I need a piece of chalk. You know where I can get any?
Why would I have any?
Just asking around.
Well, I don't play with that stuff. I've got my... well, my thoughts, and I've been reading the Bible I found in my room.
That's what it's there for. Have you seen any chalk around?
Yes. Clementine loves to draw with it.
Yeah, of course. I'll talk to her. Hey, Clementine.
Hey, Lee.
Do, you have any pink chalk?
No, it's gone somewhere. Do you want blue?
No, it's okay.
Psst, Lee.
I found something.
What is it?
I found this piece of pink chalk and a scuff of it over by the gate.
Really?
Totally. I was combing the scene for clues and...
Yeah, Duck, I got it. Good job.
Cool!
Have you found anything else?
Just the chalk. I also found some bugs underneath the stairs. Don't tell Clementine.
Okay, I won't. You didn't break the flashlight, did you, Duck?
No, Mom and Dad won't let me touch any of their stuff. Lily neither.
That's probably for the best. You seem to know a bit about all of this. The chalk, you found the scuff here. This is gonna sound crazy, but you're not involved, are you?
No, I'm a good guy.
Stay inside the gate.
I will.
More chalk. Somebody was over here, too.
See? I did good, huh?
Yeah, Duck. You did. I suppose I should go out there and look around. You stay here this time. Seriously.
Okay.
Those bandits gave us hell, but they've been quiet for days now. There's a grate down there. It's a bag of something.
You haven't come up with anything, have you?
I came up with this. It's got a bunch of meds in it. It was in a grate on the outside wall, and there's a sign on the other one.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
Okay, we line everybody up. Everybody. Somebody is killing us. Stealing from that supply is the same as slipping into your room at night and cutting your throat while you sleep. You die. What is the difference? What if Clementine gets sick and we don't have what we need? What the hell?
You don't fucking steal from us!
Who the fuck is that?
Y'all better get your ass out
here!
We got
people out there!
We ain't fucking around!
What do we do?
Oh, Lily. Shit! They're gonna start kicking in doors any second.
Lily, what the hell are you-
Stall him.
What?
Just keep him talking. Do whatever it takes to stop him pulling the trigger.
You made the biggest mistake of your lives!
Shit.
Enough of this bullshit! Drew, stop putting your boot to these doors!
Yeah!
Hold it, asshole!
Take it easy. We have more supplies. We can keep the deal going.
Too late, shithead! We ain't giving second chances.
It was a mix-up. We'll make it worth your while.
I'm listening.
We can split the supplies. Spread them around.
Or we could just kill you and take it all.
And what about when they run out? When you don't have us out there collecting them for you?
Well, I suppose we ought to hash out some terms then.
I don't like no hash.
Man, shut up, Rob!
Christ!
Oh, shit!
Get back there! Smoke him out! We gotta get out of here!
No shit!
Get those bastards! Cover our people and get them to the RV!